Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the trap series here, BusyWorksBeats.com/trap. And we're going to go over the Logic, the rapper, style trap, similar to his song Wrist with Pusha T. So let's dig into sound selection because that's the key here. So let's right click. We're going to build our sounds from scratch just to show you the process. Let's open up Silent One. You don't need this plugin to do it. You can do it in any synthesizer. Okay, if you're not familiar with sound design, go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design. We have a free course for you there. Let's go to menu, initialize preset, turn on our sawtooth. We're going to give it a nice short decay with a little release so it sounds like it has a tail to it. Pull it up an octave or two. The secret here is to give it a slight attack so it's not so transient heavy. Give it a little more release, a little more decay. Okay, now we're gonna create multiple voices for it. So four voices, let's detune. Okay, so all we're gonna do is just go upward in a scale. So let's tap out the tempo. We're gonna be at about 135 BPM. So we're going upwards, so it's going to E, E, B, C, E, E, B, C. So we're just going to copy that. Wrong note. Drop that down to A. And then we want it to finish. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Going to have it repeat. Very simple. Now, since it's a melody, we want to go to our wrench tool, turn up time shift a bit, because melodies are usually in the groove. They're not right on the downbeat. So that's why your melodies might not sound cool. It's because they're too on the grid. They're too aligned with the tempo. Let's add a little more voicing to it so it's not just a basic sawtooth. Add a sine wave. Too heavy in the low end. You can do any type of shaking one. I'm just going to use the sawtooth. Going to be the main melody. Now we are going to create another melody. Silent One again. Let's go to menu, initialize preset. Now we're going to create a bell type of tone starting with a sine wave. There's another way to create a bell tone, but I'm not going to get into that today. We go over that in our other videos. Now we're going to create on pattern two a melody that goes along with the first melody. So it's we're going to use the same principles of melody, but we're going to make them different. Mostly in time. Let's go back to Silent Once and give it decay and release just like before. Pull up the octave. Turn up my monitors a bit. Let's see. So you can contrast it. You can make this one go downward while the other one's going upward. So this is my own taste, okay? I'm adding this as my own style. I like to do a lot of octave jumps. So what I'm also going to do is take it off the grid. It's too aligned with the metronome right now. So let's go to time shift, pull that up a bit. This is similar to just moving your MIDI notes to the right a bit, taking it off the grid so it's not so aligned. You can hear it very early. I want it to repeat. I want it to do something different on the second half. And I'm gonna go boom, 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 boom. lot of half steps involved here. Let's add a high pass filter to this sound so we don't get as much lower. So let's combine those two. Now we're going to get the typical trap drums, but before we get into the drums, let's keep digging out the sounds. Let's go to Omnisphere and let's load up a choir so we can use a harmony. And I'm going to use two different vocals for Omnisphere. We're going to go to Human Voices. First, I'm going to look for a choir, like a gospel choir, or we can go with the classical. It doesn't really matter. Actually, I really like the jazz sounds. Pick any choir you want, just any harmony stack that you want. Let's hear the jazz stack. I really liked these the last time. There's a really cool one. Let me see if I can find it. Jazz. It was a jazz stack, and it had multiple... I don't know if it was that one. I think it was three. I marked it. Here we go. Okay. So I like that kind of thing. That's just my own taste. You can add the choir if you want for that trappy sound, but I want to kind of blend it with this jazz stack. I know it's kind of going against the wrist vibe, but sometimes choir gets so repetitive, you got to spice it up somehow. So this is my own touch. This is what I'm trying to show you, that the technique is that we're using vocal harmonies. That's the technique. It's not to say you have to use this choir patch or else. If you want a similar sound, you could say, okay, that's the type of choir I need. So that's a sound selection technique that we're taking out. So, you know, that's what we're going through in music production technique. We're not just copying every single element. Let's add this choir. Now, the jazz might not even work with this vibe. I'm just going off of what I like. Sounds pretty eerie. So let's figure out the chord we want to play first. And it also doesn't align with the tempo, so that might be a hindrance here, but that could be because it's not in the groove. Seems like it's just missed time. So let's go back to a regular stack. Okay, so I'm writing out the chords here. There are techniques behind this. I'm not going to explain every little thing because I go over it at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory in depth. So it's similar to a choir. Sounds pretty eerie. So I'm making a pretty long chord progression. I'll explain it in a second. So I'm using a lot of technique here. So the first chord technically is A minor. I'm just using an octave A to expand the tone. Then we're moving to F major. So these are the key triads, and then we're moving to an E minor, but I pulled down the fifth, so this makes this a flat fifth. But technically, the B is up here, so we technically are playing E minor. We're just playing A over top of it, which really makes this, if you invert it, this would be E, G, B. So that'd be like add 13, I think. So it's the first, third, fifth, seventh, ninth. So add 11. Okay, so that's what I'm doing here. A little more complicated for those who don't understand those terms. That's why I say go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Everything is there for you. Also, let me make sure the notes are not overlapping because that can cause the chord not to trigger. Now I'm going to switch up the chord, make it a little more jazzy. Pulling this up. Actually, let's not even do that. Let's just loop it. Let me hear what it sounds like in the lower octave. That's too muddy. Okay. So I'm not going to overcreate the chord progression. It's trap music. You don't have to have long, long chord progressions. What I'm going to do is take the top note of all the notes in the chord progression, and I'm going to solo that, hitting copy or control C. Let's open up Omnisphere one more time, and we're going to pull up a lead vocal this time. So let's go through human voices, and I think it's called something opera. So let's go to type, or let's go to gender, actually, female. Let's see what we can find. And forget the exact name. Oh, soprano. Here we go. So I'm going to paste this in pattern 4 in the piano roll. Here's what it sounds like. So I'm not going to have overlapping notes because it creates a weird thing with this library. That's what I'm going to add for the buildup. Pan each left and right so it gives it room to breathe. Add a little more reverb to that high synth. Give it more of a reverb tail. Notice how much we emphasize in the music before we even get to the drums. Now let's go to busyworksbeats.com and start loading up drums like the 808 from the 808 Science Drums Edition. Let's load that up. Find a nice 808 that fits the vibe. I think 808 Atom will work great for this. I'm going to normalize it. We need to right click, edit it. Let's go to the marker tab, detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of D, so let's go back. Let's go to envelopes. Let's reset our root note and right click on the root note D. I go over tuning in a completely different video. If you're still confused, go to type in tuning, BusyWorks Beats for more information. So now the 808 is tuned to the key of D. So now we can play it like any other instrument on our keyboard. We need drums, so let's go to Ultimate Producer Bundle 2. Let's load up some Fire Drum Kit, find a kick. Kick hot, open that up. We need a snare. I think we're going to combine kick flames with kick smoke because that has more of a clap tone to it in the flames and the sharpness of kick smoke. So let's send this to the mixer. These are from the Ultimate Producer Bundle 2. The new edition, Ultimate Producer Bundle 3, is coming out to busyworksbeats.com/UPB. Okay, so there are FL Studio 12 project templates for you. So I'll have more information on that soon. Let's go back to pattern 5. Let's start writing in our kicks. Now, I'm not writing in the 808 yet. typical trap. Boom, 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 boom. You know, that's been used 1,000 times, but it works. Now for kick flames, let me delay that a bit with time shift. Now the 808, I wanted to have the same rhythm as the kick, but at the end I wanted to go boom, 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 boom. So have a little more activity. So I'm going to copy and paste the kick pattern, but now we need to give it a tone, because right now we're just playing middle C, and that doesn't mean it's going to fit well musically with our song. So let's... It needs to be in A. Why we're clipping, so let's start turning stuff down. Turn my monitor up a little bit. I want to copy the pattern because the kick doesn't change, so let's just copy that over. And at the end, I want to go boom, 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 1, 2, 3. So the 808 continues, whereas the kick doesn't. Okay, so that's what I'm trying to create there. A difference between the kick and the 808. Now you can drop this down an octave if you want. I think they did that in the song, in Wrist. So let's go to Pattern, Make Unique. Change this to Pattern 7 as well. And all I'm going to do here is just go to Piano Roll, hit Control down to drop it down an octave. Okay, so it's a little deeper. You might not even be able to hear that on your system. That's so low that I don't like it. It's too low. You can't even feel it. Let's go to the hi-hats on pattern 8. Grab a hi-hat from the Ultimate Producer Bundle 2. And the hi-hats are going to be slow, but we're going to have rolls. So I'll show you what that means in a second. So what I like to do is start out with just filling each 2 steps. So right-click, fill each 2 steps. And wherever my head hears a roll, I'll add one in. So I'll show you what I mean in a second. Let me make this longer so we can, it's easier. At the end, I'm just going to add a note in. So that's the first roll. Now let's go to piano. I mean, let's go to up top, clone this. Okay, now I've heard triplets in their hi-hat rolls. So right here, I want a triplet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So let's right click, go to piano roll. I'm going to drag this note out. Change it to triplet timing, which is different from quarter timing. Let's go to 1/6 beat, hit Control U. It's too much. Let's go back to the third beat, hit Control U. Okay, so triplet timing is different from quarter timing. It goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, rather than 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It's a different rhythm. Then I want to go. I want this to roll, so let's grab that. Change it to either a half step or a quarter step. Hit Control U. The hi-hat's a little too on the grid. Let's take it off the grid a little bit with time shift. Take out the bell. Let's start soloing stuff so we can hear the musicality come out a bit more. Let's take off the bell first, and then let's take out the high synth and the, where are we at here? The lead vocal. cymbal for the downbeats. Down over time. I just want to hear what this would sound like. Okay, the sound would die out. Let me hear what this would sound like. Just to add more motion to the sound. Delay, so that might, so you might have to cut back down on the wrench tool time shift. Still a little delayed, but whatever. Let's hear it without the monitor so you don't hear all the extra bass. Let's have the song build so you're not so familiar with the 808. Where are we at here? Let's go here. So that's how you get that kind of, you know, eerie trap sound, using a lot of half step intervals and also that choir sound, as well as all the musical techniques we went over. But if you notice, we went over the music first, then the drums. Okay, so you need to learn music theory. Go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory if you want to expand your genres and expand your approach. Again, the Ultimate Producer Bundle 3 will be coming to busyworksbeats.com/UPB, and we'll have more details coming soon. Thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.